How do we make today outrageous? I think the very fact that
make me a headline, ma'am.
Oh, I make a headline with and without you. Any public person has to be extremely conscious of the fact that no matter what they say, firstly, either becomes a headline or becomes a reason so that headlines can be made.
Right.
And given that we are conscious people as public personalities, be it in media or in politics, we recognize that communication is an opportunity, can become a challenge if we don't use the tools well. Today, we are again in a time and place where most of the viewers know who is just a theorist and who is actually factually reporting from the ground. And I think that is what is extremely encouraging. I mean, I've seen 17-year-olds, I mean, I have these conversations with college kids. They tell us, "Arey, ye wala toh fake news hai." We are not looking at media as just business. And that is where the problem is.
Right.
If I know that, let's say today, if Karan Johar does something extremely outrageous on this stage, every media house will carry it. Why? Because it's news for them, it's business. And if Karan Johar has a very sedate conversation, people will just possibly carry a chota sa photo somewhere and say, "Not, aaj wo element mein nahi the."
And move on to somebody else's airport look.
Somebody else's controversy, somebody else's outrageous behavior. People do not expect outrageous behavior on a platform like this. They expect a very deliberate, a very structured, a very nice, sedate conversation, which is what we are giving them.
But we should not always serve what people want.
If you are in the business of entertainment, Mr. Johar, as you are, you have to give them what they want. When you try to give them what they do not want, it flops at the box office. It just seems bright because we have unlimited talent.
Right.
We are a country of storytellers. And I've said this on another platform recently. I said, imagine we as a nation have grown up with grandmothers telling us stories, not reading out of a book, but out of pure memory. And those stories differ from state to state. Those stories differ from district to district because our grandmothers have the potential of taking something which is very local in terms of our culture, our heritage, our craft, weave it into that story and it becomes a part of our mindset. In a country which is creative, we need to now marry that creativity with technology, how well we do it for our children. I think that's where the key lies. And I think that an empowered consumer is the best thing to happen to the media.